Welcome to another episode of Conversations in Automation with CNE Advanced Technologies. I'm your host, Donnie Bischoff, excited today to welcome Seth Carlson with Vann Engineering. Seth, how are you doing?
I'm doing good, man. Thanks for having me.
Thanks for being here. So can you tell us a little bit about yourself and your role at Vann?
Yeah, again, my name is Seth Carlson. I work for Vann Engineering as the industry specialist for material handling and logistics. Now, what does that exactly mean? I try to serve as the nexus for all things material handling for Vann, both locally, both internationally, and just trying to be that go-to resource and the industry expert in material handling.
Sure. So I'm going to go ahead and lob this question out to you. What is material handling?
That's a good question, because a lot of people have different definitions of material handling. It's getting the right package to the right person in a timely manner that allows everything to move forward. It's supply chain at its finest. If you're moving products around, and that can be done manually, semi-automatically, or totally automated, it's still a material handling system. It plays into part in so many different aspects of what we think. A lot of times we think of, you know, fulfillment centers or distribution centers as being the main hub for material handling, which it is, but it intersects into automotive areas, shipping and receiving, dock doors, all the things that may lead to and from that fulfillment center, that distribution center, which we all commonly know is material handling. It's not just the Amazons, it's not just the Chewys, it's not just these big, huge organizations that you know of. It's mom and pop shops, it's the local t-shirt manufacturer down the road. All of these people now, big and small, are having to grow and expand because of the pandemic, because of things having been done yesterday, where, you know, a few years ago, a week's time might have been acceptable. It's not acceptable anymore. We got to get things there faster. And how do we do that?
So Seth, you brought up the elephant in the room, which is the pandemic, yeah. Right? So over the past couple of years, how has that affected factories, end users, and their approach to material handling?
With the onslaught of e-commerce, the onslaught of people ordering things from their home, it's putting everyone at stress. It's putting all the systems at stress, and all those end users, those customers, are trying to do more with less on a daily basis. And how do we do more with less? We add automation to it. We find better and more acceptable ways to make systems and processes within those fulfillment centers, within those, anyone that's moving stuff, and adding automation, a lot of the products or solutions that Vann presents can help make sure we get the right product to the right person.
You answered the question I was gonna ask, which is what's some go-to products or areas to highlight then?
Yeah, one of the really cool products, or solutions I should rather say, with Vann producing is our jam detection. And one of the ways that keeps our efficiency down is jams. Something as simple as boxes piling up along a conveyor that can shut a whole process down. I was with a customer recently that had a conveyor, it was the end process conveyor. And if that conveyor went down or got jammed up, 300 people were gonna stand around with their hands in their pockets. Now, Vann found an interesting solution. We have a sensor called our jam detection sensor, which is a very elegant way to detect jams when they happen. And more importantly, prevent false jams from happening. In the past, you'd have a basic photoelectric sensor that was set up on a timer looking for gaps between packages. Our new solution, jam detection sensor, gets installed right in line with the photoelectric sensor and can look for an actual jam. Boxes can be end-to-end, running at breakneck speed. It will only declare a jam when a jam actually occurs.
Condition monitoring is a term that continues to come up in conversation. Yeah. So can you start off, explain what condition monitoring is, and then explain some of the key products that Vann has to assist customers with condition monitoring?
Yeah, condition monitoring, I mean, it's not a new concept. Monitoring equipment so we can prevent downtime, so we can prevent that equipment from failing prematurely. Prior to recently, it didn't make a whole lot of sense to put a vibration monitoring or temperature monitoring on a small gearbox driving a conveyor, right? The return investment didn't make sense. It was too expensive to justify monitoring that gearbox because that gearbox was pretty cheap to replace. But we have to change our thinking a little bit. We're not so much concerned, you know, our customers, I should say, are not so much concerned about the cost of that gearbox or the cost of that conveyor. The throughput is what they're worried about. So taking our solution, which kind of fit an interesting gap between very robust systems that, you know, were very, very expensive that would only be justified putting on high-end pieces of equipment, and having a guy walk around with a probe and measuring those things on rounds, our solution fits right onto these sites. You know, we call it peel and stick, essentially. It goes right into motors, and we can measure things in real time right at the sensor level and give actionable data to the end user, to that maintenance provider. So we know, hey, this motor's going down, it's gonna go down soon, and we can plan our downtime, we can plan our outages, we can plan, you know, our work around that thing so it's not going down unexpectedly, especially, you know.
I know that one thing that's really interesting that a lot of our customers find very intriguing
is when they set up the cloud-based service, right? They log into their account. That dashboard is automatically populated.
Yep, straightforward.
So what are the, some of the things that they're seeing when they log in and take a look? So that,
well, I mean,
is it user friendly?
It's super user friendly. You mean it's, you know, it almost comes down to the simple, you know, the green, yellow, red. You can look at your dashboard, everything is green. Hey, all our motors are ticking along just fine. We don't need to worry about anything. Clicks to yellow, hey, there's something going on with this motor, something going on with this gearbox. We need to send someone out there to take a look at it. And to tie into that, it's the notifications. It's not just, you know, how much someone have to look at it, email notifications, push notifications, you know, the data is being looked at right there at the sensor. And it's allowing the end user a little bit of a hands-off experience to say, hey, these things are being monitored. I'm going to be able to know when something is going awry well beforehand and be able to adjust my maintenance plan accordingly.
And as I understand it, that can be completely independent of the IT infrastructure that's at that company.
Yeah, our wireless tech, if we're going the wireless route, we have totally, you know, proprietary wireless technology that keeps it totally void or totally independent of the in-house IT structure, which is the first question everyone gets asked when you walk into a customer and say, oh, we want to do some wireless technology, we want to do condition-based monitoring. IT is going to go, what?
Absolutely.
No, it's a big hurdle to usually get across, and we've been able to do that very well with our proprietary technology.
Excellent. So you highlighted something that I think is very critical and interesting. So the different communication protocols that we see at different facilities.
Yeah.
The SNAP signal.
Yeah.
Right. Can you just highlight a little bit on how cool that is and what that does?
It's really cool. We have, you know, SNAP signal is a whole web of communication protocols that allows IO-Link and Modbus and Ethernet IP to all communicate together, which before they were very, you know, much on their own island. You know, they didn't talk. You'd have to adopt one wholly and go with that if you wanted to talk to something else. Now with our converters, these little tiny converters that are, you know, all of a sudden they allow a huge network to be connected that otherwise would never have been able to be connected.
So one of the hottest things that's going on right now in material handling and the new wave of automation is the introduction of cobots and AMRs.
Yeah.
So where's Banner playing in that realm?
Yeah, it's an interesting topic I love to talk about because they're not something that's coming. They're here now. And Banner's playing a huge role in adding to these robots, making them more effective, making them, you know, work better. And one of the big part of it is our safety products. You know, more and more robots are entering these facilities, more and more robots are becoming ubiquitous. Well, how do we keep robots and humans interacting in a safe manner? You know, the use of safety scanners, the use of safety light curtains, making sure that, hey, if a human is getting too close to that robotic cell, alarms are going off. We have this cool setup with one of our safety scanners, and you know, it's casts out an array of lasers that if you enter that array anywhere, programmable to however big or small you want it, if you enter that array, it sends off a warning, and then we have our lighting products that will go around the hard guarding to light up the whole thing like a Christmas tree, is like I like to say. You know, it's being creative with lighting. LED technology has allowed us to link up sensors, to link up our safety scanners to our lighting. I've been very impressed with how creative customers can get in partnership with us of how we can use lighting to better, you know, aid indication and illumination in their factories.
What I think is kind of unique what Banner does with lighting, right? When you're continuing to try to enhance a safety feature with lighting, with your Pro Series, you have the ability to continue to edit the colors, the flashes, the shapes, right? Which saves on reordering or ordering a different color or a cover. With the Pro Series, you can kind of edit as you go to continue to enhance. Is that correct?
Yeah, 100%. I mean, we from the Pro Series, that essentially you have a, I always say get creative because the world is your oyster. It's totally endless. We have a light bar that can be essentially any color under the rainbow and can do any sort of pattern, anything you want to. And the applications are endless, from a pick to light to, you know, lighting up a light bar to indicate where someone needs to grab a part and where they need to not grab a part, to lighting up that robotic cell and flashing and whirling, to you know, putting on top of an AGV on top of a autonomous forklift, you know, to indicate status of that forklift, where it's headed, you know, one color to make sure it's headed to the dock, one color to make sure it's heading away from the dock, one color to say it's got an issue. You know, it's the possibilities are endless.
So at the end of the day, when we're talking about improvements in the material handling vertical and the manufacturers that serve it, essentially we're talking about cost savings.
Yeah, it truly does come to cost savings. It comes down to how do we most effectively improve our throughput through our entire facilities for all of our customers, getting those things from point A to point B, making sure we have actionable data to make good decisions to, again, improve that throughput. And finally, helping our customers make a quality product, you know, using our solutions to improve their products to do all those things that much better.
Seth, thanks for joining us today. The little bit of time we got to know each other, I know you could talk about material handling all day long. The cool thing is you can dial Seth up, ask him those questions, contact Sini Advanced Technologies. We'd love to talk about the cool things Banner's doing specifically in the material handling vertical. Thanks for joining again. We'll see you next time with Conversations in Automation.